Okay, so here is a Sanyo cassette deck. It has no overcurrent protection in it from the factory. And as you can see, the power goes straight from the transformer, from the cord, right to the transformer with no fuse and no protection of any kind. Okay, the camera's rolling.
Am I in it too?
Yep, you're in it.
So do you want to tell them why we put these fuses in?
Yes.
Yep.
We're going to use one of these in there, so I got to keep it out. Are these the 1 amps?
Yeah.
All right, the reason why we do this is because of the filament inside the house fuse is bigger than this one. So if this thing shorts out and burns out the cord, it'll burn out the cord, or it'll burn out this fuse before it can get the house fuse very hot and cause a fire when this cord catches fire or gets hot. That's why we do it.
And the UL and the Product Safety Commission should require these fuses.
And it's also a shock hazard, too.
Right, because it can make the metal chassis live or metal chassis type of products.
Yep.
Okay, so let's see the sandpaper there.
All right. Okay, there's the fuse for it.
Okay, so we're going to sand our terminals here so we have a nice flow of solder.
This is one we picked up at the discount yard.
Wouldn't you say UL and the Product Safety Commission should require this fuse as a basic fire prevention?
Yes, they should. Yeah, they should.
And tell them that the fuse, 20 amp fuse is equal to the 20 amp circuit breaker.
Yeah, and the 20 amp fuse is equal to the circuit breaker. So while this is supposed to trip if there's a problem, but if this shorts out, the secondary shorts out on this, it could cause this transformer to overheat and could melt the plastic and cause a fire before it trips the house breaker.
Okay, we're going to look at our plug. It's not polarized. Okay, so I'm going to... Do you have those side covers?
Yes, I do. I got them. Yeah.
Yep. All the strands and
so we have that. The metal flake went in there, it's stuck right to the side. Get that off there, yep. Metal flake stuck in there.
Oh,
I put that in the right place.
Okay. Yeah. And I'll start this over.
Yep.
not the middle of 25 inch.
Do you want the short and the full and the short anything out?
Yes, kind of pitch.
I gotta get that brush for the alcohol.
Okay, hold on, I'll go past the camera.
Okay.
Oh, no, don't.
No, we'll get it after.
We'll get it after. We'll just keep doing it after. We'll get it after. I'll go back.
A little applicator.
Oh, yes, I got it.
Oh, never mind. I'll just use the end of the wire there.
Okay. All right. I got a hand. I'm gonna go get my hand right here. I got something to use.
Oh, the screwdriver. I'll
use a flat screwdriver. Yeah. That'll work out good. Stuff in the water
now. No, UL should not. Cheap safety when it comes to the cheaper units, shouldn't they?
Yes, yeah, this is a cheap unit, but they still should not cheap out on the fuses. Because it's still a fire hazard.
Both UL and the Product Safety Commission should require it, shouldn't they?
Yes, they should. Yep. They should require a fuse, for sure.
Okay, boy, that looks like a nice solder joint.
Oh, yes, it does. How about the other side?
The other side?
Beautiful.
Yep,
beautiful. Okay. Make sure we get all our strands in there, not miss any.
Yeah, and not have any breaks.
Breaks, yeah.
Oh, nice clean cut.
Nice clean cut. And the wire's nice and clean, too. It's not oxidized. Beautiful.
Because when it was oxidized, it makes it a lot harder.
Makes it a lot harder to do it, yeah.
I'm going to make sure all the strands go into the hog here.
Yes. Sorry. Did I sneeze?
Yeah. Oops, the strand came out.
Oh, did it? Okay, I'm gonna redo it then.
I'm gonna twist these together a little bit more.
On there. Not too much.
Alright.
On the bottom. Okay. You see the roll of solder too. I'll deal with that too. I put a little too much flux on that. I did. It's a little bit too much.
Too much is better than not.
Yes, exactly.
That's auto drive.
Oh, that looks good. That top looks good. How about the bottom now?
I just let that
cool a little bit. Oh, beautiful.
Beautiful.
Nice. Okay. I like that, Dan.
Yes, I do.
You got a strip. Now, this one, I'm not going to twist the strands together because...
We're going to twist them around the leg of the post of the transformer.
I'm going to come around this way with it.
Do it with the fingers, then do it with the pliers, right?
Yes.
And make it really tight with the pliers. A tight twist.
I'm going to do a regular solder on this one.
Okay.
Not the drop solder. Okay, so I'm going to turn it so people can see us soldering.
I'm going to do that on regular solder. Okay, regular solder does that.
I'm going to just touch
a little bit more on the top there.
Now it's nice and small.
Let me even let it cool.
Now we're going to screw out to mount it.
This deck was made in 84, according to the date.
It's not very old, then.
It says 01-03-84. So that means 84, right? 1984.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, a cutter that I could cut the screw with.
You didn't bring yours?
No, I forgot it.
Uh-oh. I don't think I have anything. Let's see. Hold on a minute. Let me go, okay, pause the camera, yeah. I don't think I have anything now, but let me see if I can see.
Okay, so now we'll snug this
bolt
on here.
Fuses right over there by the iron. Christmas tags, would you?
I don't think we're going to have to put
it back to a tag.
Okay, I'm going to straighten this just a little bit more here. It's a little bit crooked. Now that's nice and perfectly straight. Putting in our 1-amp fuse, so now this does have overcurrent protection that the UL and the manufacturer and the factory should have required in the first place. And I'll put a zip tie right here.
Make it look like factory work was done.
Yes.
Something just dropped in there.
Okay, now I'll bring the camera down and show people up close what it looks like all done. And there's what our work looks like after it's all done. So UL, the manufacturer, and the Product Safety Commission should have required it in the first place, shouldn't they?
Yes, they should have, yep.
And there's the front of the unit.
Yep.